better not be any other breakers tonight.
Plasma will make quick work of it. Be ready.
Any sign of Caro's lackeys?
If that outlander takes her fate, I'll duck.
Fuck!
save the extra stock for later. Let's go.
Hey!
Intruder!
You see her? Cover the way, Juicy! Knew I'd find ya!
Just fold it. What the heck is room? Robles must be stripping them for parts.
What's that? Halt, Outlander! Intruder!
There.
I lost the hostile.
I should check if there's anything with a lock around here. The area should be safe now. For the next fight. least for these soon enough. I can open that locked chest. I wonder if this key will open that chest. Tags from fallen soldiers. I should get these back to Duca. Fire's wasted on that machine. cool. It is hot.
Thank you.
I wonder what a merchant would trade for this. shelter. Should be safe here.
Thank you.
can grab this from my stash later. snow crunch under my boots.
Mr. Know-It-All is here. You know, your focus buddy who never smiles. I didn't know what to do with him, so I had him wait in your room.
Got it. Thanks. Well, Silence, looks like you finally found a door you could open without me.
I'm glad it's there, actually. It kept me from having to mingle with the company you keep. But enough prattle. I believe you owe me an explanation. Your plans for the Zenith base.
You're right. I do owe you. My spear in your throat for deceiving me again. At the Hades Proving Lab.
I doubt you asked me here for that kind of reckoning.
No. Right now, I need your help. So I'm giving you one final chance. But if you ever betray me again, I will kill you no matter what the circumstance. Understood?
Very well. Though we'll both face a decidedly short future if you can't get us inside that base.
Aloy, your other guest is here. She's, coming to you.
Thanks. Good timing. The truth is, I can't actually get us into the base. But she can.
The company you keep is even worse than I thought.
Not a fan of surprises, are you? Well, look. That must be your little invention.
Does the weapon work? Without self-destructing?
Of course it does. I've eliminated the imperfections and greatly improved its design and output.
How can we be sure?
Care for a demonstration.
Enough, both of you. We're in this together, at least for now. Go talk to Erend. Tell him I said to give you rooms of your own. I'll come see you when I get a chance.
Oh, no. You first.
Better get everyone in the control room so Tilda can tell us what she knows about the Zenith base. When it looks impossible, look deeper. And then fight like you can win. I will, Rost. Now, and always. With Regala out of the way, Hikaru and Zanok, they're safe. The future's up to them now. I do wish they'd drop all the honorary names they've given me. But if I've learned anything about them, that is not a battle I am going to win. Focus. It's Whirls. I used to think no Nora would ever accept one. Varl did. Even when he was overwhelmed, he refused to let me push him away. failed, Varl. At Gemini. I should have pushed harder. I should have done more. I'd give anything to have him back.
Machine strike together.
Oh no. I got enough trouble with Gonzalo. I was kicking my ass.
You still got any good at it?
The way my luck's going, I'll bet you're a pro.
Just you wait, Varl. We're taking those space lugs out.
I wonder how much snow is going to pile up.
Never thought I'd see metal bound to flesh in that way.
Aloy, you came back with some interesting friends.
Wish I could say we don't need them, but Silence and Tilda are here for a reason. Even Regala.
Yeah. Enemy of my enemy and all that, right?
Right. Doesn't look like any of our guests are making trouble.
Yet. So, Katala tells me you flew. Well, that's new. I've been busting my balls trying to learn to read. You're out there having all the fun.
Don't worry. You'll be getting all the fun you can handle soon. With the Zeniths.
Looking forward to it.
You, talked to Tilda at all?
I tried. I don't think even a hot forge could melt that ice. And you say she wants to help?
I think so. Well, let's hope. I guess Silence is keeping to himself, as usual.
I was hoping he'd give me an excuse to hammer his sorry ass to the ground.
Please don't.
You telling me you wouldn't want to get just one good hit on that smug face of his? After everything he's done?
Sure. Later. Right now, he's got something we need. I better get going.
Oh, you know where to find me.
Aloy. It appears that we have some interesting new guests. I'm glad to see you're okay, though. I heard you gave the Tanakh something to talk about. I was half expecting you to burst in through the ceiling riding a Sunwing.
Sorry to disappoint. Thoughts on our new Zenith acquaintance?
I'd say she smells like death, but even death smells of something. She's more like a cold piece of metal, bent on repelling all semblance of life.
She's definitely different. Ready to head over to the Zenith base?
Whatever comes, we will endure.
Have you talked to any of our new friends?
Erend and I tried speaking to Silence, but apparently our tribal prattle is unnecessary.
Charming, isn't he? I have to go. I trust you to keep things civil around here.
I'll make sure Erend doesn't punch Silence in the face, if that's what you mean.
Thanks.
You flew? Katala told me. And took out Regala's machines? You know what? I don't even know why I'm surprised. I saw we have visitors and a new weapon. Does this mean we're ready to take the fight to the Zeniths?
Almost. I suppose you saw that Tilda is here. Our very own Zenith.
I almost went up to her to ask her, well, every question I've ever had about the legacy. Every diviner I know would kill to get 5 minutes with one of the old ones. But now that she's here, all I feel is a vague unease. I don't know if I'm scared of finding out more uncomfortable truths or just scared of her. Probably both.
You sure you're okay going on this mission? I know things must be happening pretty fast for you.
I've already braved oceans and madmen who thought they were ancestors reborn. Why not a few immortals with lethal drones at their command, too?
Guess the more the merrier. Are you okay?
I was wondering, is it really safe having someone like Regala here? She seems angry. The kind of angry that leads to murdering people in their sleep.
Don't worry. We're going to point that anger in the right direction. The Zeniths.
If you say so.
I hope our new guests have been behaving.
The Silence. He's the one who built the weapon that can take down Zenith shields?
He is. Though I wouldn't expect him to answer any questions about it. He refuses to dole out his secrets to us lesser mortals.
Oh.
You know that special part of us that makes us warm, kind, welcoming?
Our spirit?
Yeah. He was born without that. I need to wrap up a few things, but stay sharp.
I'll be ready when you call.
I see you've got your new arm ready to go.
Yes. It still feels strange. I've gotten used to the absence, but no matter. I'm sure I will need it before the attack on the Zenith base is through.
Haven't seen you since the battle at the Grove. How are you holding up?
I saw you fly on the wings of the Ten. And paralyze Regala's army with lightning. I would say that I am inspired.
Thank you, I guess.
It is I who should be thanking you.
Did you meet Tilda?
There is something about her that doesn't seem natural. I wouldn't be surprised if my sword went through her and she didn't bleed at all.
Honestly, with her, nothing would surprise me. Things will get ugly once the Zeniths realize we're in their base. You'll need every trick you've ever learned.
I would have it no other way. Many soldiers died in the old world to make sure we stood here today. We will endure on their behalf. Though, I am curious how you intend to defeat the Zeniths' defenses. Without an army of our own.
Leave that to me. Just make sure you're ready to fight.
As you say. You have more than earned my trust.
Think you're ready to put all your training to the test?
I am T'Nacht. I am always ready.
Look. I know you're probably not happy about keeping Regala around, but I want her on our side when we fight the Zeniths.
It is more than she deserves. Even so, I will not question your judgment.
Thank you, Catalo. Are you nervous about the mission ahead?
If I live, it will be in victory. If I die, it will be in battle. What matters most is that you achieve your objective.
I'll do my best. Anything new going on I should know about?
The Quen has been more insistent than usual, asking about the visions at the Grove. Her pursuit of knowledge is relentless. The Ten would have a hard time fighting her off.
Just think of her like one of your chaplains.
Yes. Only more persistent.
Your people keep mentioning the wings of the Ten.
The visions T'An leapt in for us. It is why the challenge... And now, like the deeds of the Ten themselves, it will never be forgotten. So, tell me. How did it feel?
I won't lie. Pretty good.
I can only imagine.
What did Chief Akaro say when you told him he'd be joining me here?
You spilt rebel blood at the Grove and helped reunite the clans. There was little more to be said. He understood.
Well, I'm honored he lent me his best marshal. At least for a little while.
Indeed.
Why did Takote think you wouldn't be a threat to him if he sent you to the Kulrut?
Takote knew that if I survived the Kulrut, I'd be forced to forsake the clan to serve the Tanakh as a whole. I'd never be allowed to challenge his command, even if I wanted to. After our victory at Baron Light, Takote spoke to our people, said it would be selfish to rob Hikaru and the marshals of a warrior like myself, even though he knew perfectly well I had no intention of ever leaving. It was exile, guised as an honor. One he knew I couldn't refuse. So I became a marshal, and never looked back.
I'm sorry you had to go through that.
I am not. Though it pained me at the time, a marshal is what I was destined to be.
I have to go. But I'll be briefing everyone on the plan soon.
Understood.
There you are. Well done, Aloy. Despite my reservations, you managed to secure Silence and his weapon. You're truly a shining example of Liz's fortitude.
I've been thinking about what you said at your house. How you were friends with Elizabeth. It was more than that, wasn't it?
Perceptive as ever. You're right, we were together for a time.
Okay, so what happened?
I was an orphan. I had always been alone. By my 30s, I was starting to wonder if that was simply my fate in life. And then I met Liz. We kept running into each other at conferences. We'd have coffee. At some point, it became drinks. I thought it was just shop talk, an exchange of ideas, but then I was surprised at how much I looked forward to seeing her. Soon we were flying halfway across the world every other week just to meet up. For the first time, I didn't feel lonely. I could imagine a future where I wasn't. I think Liz felt the same way at first. She had lost her mother a few years back. I filled a void for her. I know I did. But as time passed, it seemed as though she wanted less, and I wanted more. And so we ended things.
So helping me, restoring Elizabeth's dream, it's what?
A second chance, yes. I made a mistake leaving Earth while Liz stayed behind. I should have done more. So when I saw you, a woman who has carved her own remarkable path, beyond even what made Liz a phenomenon, I knew I had to help you. To do right by her.
Why do you think Elizabeth pulled away?
I've wondered that for a thousand years. She was brilliant. Visionary. She cared so deeply for the world, for the betterment of humanity. But it also felt like she kept everyone at arm's length, including me. She never wanted to share her burdens. I think, in the end, she had a core that she never let anyone be part of. Sometimes I wonder if anyone really knew her.
Why did you make the data channel look like your house?
I built that house as a shelter to weather any storm. a safe place, not just for me, but for the art stored in its depths. Cultural artifacts of incalculable value. Truly, some of the greatest achievements of human civilization.
And you wanted Beta to see them?
Yes. Her upbringing was so cold and technical. I thought if she could experience Vermeer and Rembrandt, it would bring something else into her life. A heritage every bit as valuable as the scientific and technical data being drummed into her. I'm sorry I had to cut off contact, but I'll never regret sharing this house with her. She needed its shelter even more than I did.
You said before that you're not like the others, Eunice. That you never were. But you went along with all of their plans.
Out of necessity. I'm not proud of it. But complicity became a means of survival, both when Earth was consumed and when the colony on Sirius was destroyed. I did what I had to. But I resolved to remain one step ahead of the others, to try to undo what damage I could. Hence the data channel with Beta. The secret passage into their base and the little trick I pulled to save you.
When it's time to break into the Zenith base, what can we expect?
I'll go over the full layout once you've assembled your friends. Suffice it to say, we will need to push as fast as possible to Beta and Gaia's location, dealing with heavy resistance along the way. There are also printing facilities where the others have been amassing the natural resources they've stripped from the region.
What for?
First for use in the base's infrastructure, and then to fabricate more Spectre drones, a small army of them.
When I was out in the wilds, I saw a shuttle take off from the island, heading for space.
It was likely ferrying materials to and from our ship in orbit. After hundreds of years luxuriating in our digital comforts, the ship was barely space-worthy when we made our escape. Disaster can strike at any moment, we've learned our lesson.
Have you figured out how Silence's weapon works?
No, and he's been very careful not to allow me near it. I'll admit it bothers me, but regardless of how it functions, I am confident it will deactivate the other shields en masse.
How many of them are in the base?
10, including Eric and Gerard. Only a handful of us made it to our ship when our colony collapsed.
So, Eric, was he always a bloodthirsty psychopath?
I believe he got worse over time. On Earth, he was the founder of a profitable private military company. A band of cutthroats, in other words. Even as governments abandoned human combatants in favor of automated warfare, he found success with clientele that required a more personal touch. There were also rumors that he personally hunted and killed his targets. On occasion, all for the thrill of it. But on Sirius, he retreated to virtual reality simulations. In them, he could go on rampages as violent as he pleased, though I suspect with diminishing satisfaction.
All of his tribe believes he was one of the greatest people from the old world.
Then they would be quite disappointed to meet him. Though I'm sure he'd bask in the adoration.
What can you tell me about Gerard?
He was the head of the world's largest financial conglomerate, and as such, had dealings with almost every major corporation. It made him one of the wealthiest people on Earth, and certainly the wealthiest among Far Zenith.
What does one person do with that much money?
Buy more power, more influence. Gerard's always believed himself to be a refined patrician, able to maintain control with a polished smile. But beneath that exterior is a cold and calculating operator. It was his decision to restrict Beta's upbringing to her digital educators, the avatars of the Apollo database, while we were painted as her benefactors.
Well, we'll deal with him soon enough, and the others.
I would very much like to see his face when he realizes we've beaten him.
When I was in the ruins of Vegas, I found data on a man named Stanley Chen. I think he was a Zenith.
Stanley, ever the optimist. He was one of the good ones. When we established our colony, he built an exact replica of Las Vegas in virtual reality. Lights, shows, gambling, every detail perfectly recreated. And while others cloistered themselves in their own fantasies, he flung his doors wide to everyone.
The way you're talking about him, I'm guessing he didn't make it back to Earth?
No, he perished when our colony was destroyed. He would have been thrilled to discover that part of his beloved city survived.
When Beta escaped and hid in an ancient research facility, I saw another one of the Zeniths, Verbena. Who was she?
A dull star amidst a sea of brighter constellations. Unlike most of Far Zenith's members who amassed their wealth through shrewd business deals and technological achievements, Verbena inherited her billions. Her father had achieved great success in the luxury holotourism industry. At age 24, she became the world's most eligible bachelorette, branding herself a life designer, someone who leverages their fame to influence the choice of others.
What? Like a cult?
In a way, yes.
Well, she must have done something right to have survived this long.
She was her own brand of ruthless. That much is true. But even rats can cling to a vessel for escape.
Okay, so I've had run-ins with a handful of Zeniths. What about the rest?
An array of the wealthiest people on Earth. Titans of their industries.
And let me guess, all selfish and ruthless to the core?
Most, but not all. There were a few with whom I got along. Annika Mirjani, for instance, was always delightful. She founded the Holonet's most successful dance channel and was herself mesmerizing to watch. And I had fascinating discussions with Song Zhao about her work in cellular biology. Our immortality treatments are due in part to her achievements. But then there were others like Devin Miller, the CEO of a fast food printing corporation. His only real preoccupations were perfecting his golf swing and taking self-hollows. When I think about all of us, we really should have accomplished more. We had eternity.
Okay. I'll let you know when it's time.
I'll be here until then. And thank you, Aloy, for giving me this chance. My past has always been a struggle. More than once, I've lost everything. But when I look to the future, I see Liz's dream fulfilled. A universe of new possibilities.
Maybe we can make it happen.
We will. I won't let anything get in the way. I promise you that.
I just know they meant a lot to you, and,
Did you need something? Bravo. You managed to sway a Zenith to your side. Care to explain?
Not a chance. I thought you said the weapon was ready.
There's always room to optimize. But that's not why you're here. I assume you want to comprehend my undertakings, so ask away.
Since when were you so forthcoming?
Since you turned this into a waiting game. And as it seems you have found modest success, perhaps I'm willing to be generous.
Okay, so your big plan, everything you've been manipulating for the last few months. Let me see if I got this straight. You learned about the Zenith from Hades when you interrogated it. Then you came up with a plan to defeat them by using a Tanakh army and that weapon. And to get the Tanakh to fight for you, you, or rather the sons of Prometheus, armed Regala's rebels with override tech.
Did you have an actual question, or are you still playing catch-up?
So all this time, even before I found the coordinates at the Spire, you were out here scheming. Why couldn't you just tell me?
When I learned of the Zenith's return to Earth, I laid out my plans. I knew I would one day require an army of overzealous Tanakh to assault the Zenith base. The casualties would be extreme. And I knew you would never allow such a sacrifice, no matter how necessary. Thus, I devised a means to remove your interference from the equation at the Hades Proving Lab.
You wanted me to surrender to the Zenith at the Hades Proving Lab. They almost killed me.
Based on everything I knew about them, I concluded they would find you a useful asset, thereby keeping you out of harm's way and, more importantly, out of my way.
So you really didn't know they had their own clone of Elizabeth?
No. Unfortunately, there was no way I could have known that particular detail.
Detail? Well, I guess if it wasn't for that, we wouldn't be here today. Why create the Sons of Prometheus? You didn't need a Sarah to make override tech.
They were a necessary safeguard. My time serving Hades in the Eclipse demonstrated the risks of getting directly involved. Through the Sons of Prometheus, I could execute my plans, all while remaining anonymous.
Except to a Sarah. How did you get a Sarah to work for you?
I knew there was an associate of the Oseram tinker, Durval, who escaped his failed assault on Meridian. It was trivial to track her down and gain her cooperation. She wanted to succeed where Durval had failed.
So you promised her Regala and the Tanakh. The Sarah would help you create a machine-riding army that wanted to see Meridian burn as much as she did.
And so a partnership was born out of thirst for blood, bonded in mutual self-interest.
You think you had everything figured out, huh?
I did.
Tell me about the weapon. How does it work?
I've upgraded the delivery system. It now emits a wave-like effect covering a significant distance.
That doesn't fully answer my question.
No, but I'd be a fool to reveal its inner workings. After all, why did you withhold your plan for dealing with the Zenith drones? Yes. Even you can appreciate the value of secrecy when warranted. Suffice it to say that the weapon will work. The intricacies of how is knowledge that is mine alone.
Why help Regala take over? If you wanted an army, you could have just gone to Hikaru.
Before Regala's rebellion, Hikaru was only concerned with battling machines and fostering friendships with the Karja. Even if I gained his ear, he would never agree to send his forces to battle a threat he couldn't understand.
So helping a bloodthirsty exile was easier?
Yes. Exceedingly so. All Regala craved was war against the Karja and anyone who threatens the Tanakh. She would have led the tribe into battle without question, which was precisely what I needed.
While I was out there, I had a couple run-ins with the Quen.
The tribe from across the ocean. And?
Their entire tribe was shaped around the discovery focuses. One of them, Alva, even joined me here. Don't you want to know more about them?
No. They stumbled upon the greatest technological artifact from the ancient world, and what did they do with it? They shrouded the knowledge they unearthed in mysticism and taboo, creating a pantheon out of corporate shields.
Yes, well, it also led them to Thebes.
Did it now?
So those run-ins with the Quinn I mentioned. On one of them, I teamed up with their expedition to search Thebes. We found Pharaoh at the end.
You must have needed Omega clearance. So, what was it like?
Worse than you can imagine.
He single-handedly wiped out collective human knowledge. I'm sure it was still less than he deserved.
Let me guess. You would have scraped him into a jar so you could prod his brain, like what you did with Hades.
For a start.
All right, Silence. I think I've talked to you long enough. I'll let you know when it's time to go. And try not to mess with Tilda while you're in here, okay? I don't need the two of you butting heads.
Ah, yes. About your Zenith ally. I wonder if you understand what kind of person you're dealing with. For someone to live as long as she has, outlast as many calamities, well, your goals may be aligned now, but I'd watch for the moment they diverge.
Yeah, I'm aware. Reminds me of someone else I know.
Survival is only a necessity to my greater purpose, Aloy. I'd hoped you'd recognize that by now.
Do you know something or not?
Oh, I know a great deal of things. But on this, just call it a feeling.
Oh, a feeling? You mean you finally had one? Huh. Guess even you can change, Silence.
That fabrication terminal has been very useful. Your Zenith friend has been smart enough not to come in here.
Data looks fun.
So, you return.
This place smells wrong. No sand or wind, only cold steel. And the others up there, your squad.
They can hold their own. As for this base, it may not be what you're used to, but it is a shelter.
Call it what it is. A cage.
You came here on your own.
For the battle you promised. So for now I wait in my cage for your word. Tell me when to strike.
The whole time I've been in the West, I've been fighting you and your rebels. I'd at least like to know why.
You were among the enemy. What more is there to know?
Why did you do it?
Dorok, Jiroka, Makalo, and the Karja pushed into the desert to raid our people. My brother's squad was among the first to intercept them. But the Karja captured them, strung them up, and burned them alive as an example. It was too late. I found them by the sound of their screams.
So you wanted vengeance?
Vengeance? No. I wanted devastation. To tear down the Karja's cities and drown the land in blood. Hunt down every last survivor and grind their bones until the sky chokes on the dust. But my chief betrayed me. Betrayed the Tanakh.
How did Hikaru betray you?
Hikaru called on the clans to resist the Karja's red raids. But we did more than just defend. We hunted them. And they fled as children before a pack of claw striders all the way to their border. There we ripped down their stone walls. Their domain was ours for the taking. But when it came time to push on, Hikaru ordered us to fall back. What soldier retreats when slaughter is at hand?
The kind who wants peace for their people.
Peace is just a lull between vendettas. But I thought my chief had greater tactics than mine, so I stood by him, even when he allowed that filthy Karja to join our ranks.
Fashav.
I enjoyed watching him die at the embassy. He should have been put down when we first captured him on the field. Instead, Hikaru made him a marshal.
Fashav told me how he became a marshal. He earned it just like any Tanakh.
It was an insult. No outlander can ever deserve to wear our armor, bear our marks. And then a Karja messenger was brought before us. That's when I knew. I had to run my blade through Hikaru and drag his treacherous corpse to the gates of the sun.
What happened when the Karja messenger appeared before Hikaru?
The quivering priest bore a message from their new king. No more war. No more raids. Suddenly the Karja wanted to talk peace. An embassy at the very fortress we tore down. A true Tanakh would never take a Karja truce. Their blood exists to be spilled. But Hikaru lapped up the priest's message. He showed himself a Karja-loving traitor when he accepted. That's when I challenged him.
And lost.
His mercy was just another sign of his weakness. I vowed never to rest until the debt was repaid. With him on his knees before me. So with an army of soldiers and machines at my back, I returned. The day you got in my way.
The deal you made. Override tech in exchange for an assault on the Zenith base. How did Silence approach you?
That name means nothing to me. My agreement was with the Osirama Sera and her sons of Prometheus.
So all this time, you didn't even know who you were really dealing with? And you trusted an outlander?
If it was a trick, I would have crushed her. But she spoke with the same burning hatred for the Karja. And she offered me the chance to run them down with machines. The terror in your enemy's eyes when they see you charge. You know what I'm talking about. I bet you felt it.
I don't think so. What about your end of the deal? Would you have honored it?
Had I killed Akaro and become chief, these Xenoths would have been the first of the tribe's victories. But because of you, my people will continue to consort with the enemy. A tribe of weaklings.
Because of me, hundreds of Tanakh won't throw away their lives in a battle they can't win. Are you really going to fight alongside me?
I have no reason to betray you.
Really?
I failed to kill Hakaro. Failed to eliminate you. No Tanakh would follow me now. The Karjar remain out of my reach, cowering behind their walls. All I have left are the screams of those long dead and unending rage. So show me where to bury.
Are you really going to fight alongside me?
I have no reason to betray you.
Really?
I failed to kill Hakaro. Failed to eliminate you. No Tanakh would follow me now. The Karjar remain out of my reach, cowering behind their walls. All I have left are the screams of those long dead and unending rage. So show me where to bury.
All right. I guess we'll both face the end soon enough.
Ever since you got in my way, I've wanted to see your bones burned white beneath the sun. But if I'm to die in battle, then it might as well be with the one who flew the wings of the Ten.
I'll let you know when it's time to move out.
Go.
your blade be bright.
May your enemies fall.
Walk among
us. Hey, it's Akaro's champion. The Tanakh welcome you.
Walk with pride.
You flew on the wings of the Ten.
Medals are given to the best.
Face off against machines and prove your worth to the clan, Veer. Better ready yourself.
Thank you.
Seeing you in the arena always makes for quite a thrill.
Our strength is your own. Okay. So I asked the chaplain the other day, how did the Ten find them?
It is
your
honor, Outlander.
Strike true, Ten.
It's gonna be harder to see in the snow.